Now that War of the Bounty Hunters issue number 5 is out, it had so many storylines inside of it that it needed to be dissected beat by beat. In fact, this issue had about 32 to 33 pages itself, because issue number 5 concludes the War of the Bounty Hunter series. Now we're gonna get the Crimson Dawn series, but last time we left Luke and Darth Vader, they were gunning for each other, father against son, pilot against pilot, who was the best. For a short while there, we saw Luke besting Darth Vader, which was kind of fascinating to see. You could see that Luke's progression is going just fine. However, Darth Vader does not relent so easily. He went on to fix his ship quite quickly and immediately went gunning for Luke Skywalker again. However, the Lambda shuttle that is holding Han Solo has been captured by the Hutt Council, led by Boku the Hutt. Admiral Piet, in fact, informs Vader of this. Now we see Vader hunting down Luke and getting agitated for about this news. "You should not have disturbed me for such insignificance, Admiral Piet. The activities of the Hutts are irrelevant to me. But if Captain Solo is not aboard the Executor by the time I return, I will require an explanation. In person." I'm sure this left Admiral Piet shaking in his boots. "Yes, Lord Vader, understood," says Admiral Piet. "Do not contact me again unless the Emperor himself orders it. I have a target of my own," as we see a determined Luke and R2 trying to get away as fast as possible. "We need more speed, R2," says Luke. "We have to stay ahead of him." All right, calm down. "I know you're doing your best. Open a channel to the Falcon." The Falcon, though, was not doing much better. Leia was just desperate, but Luke was as well. "Your engines are out." He couldn't believe that the Falcon's engines are out, but he had his own problems to deal with. In the end, Admiral Piet was capable of saving the Lambda shuttle that was safely escorted to the Executor. However, even the Hutt fighters had started relenting. But this is a time where we see Admiral Piet making his move. The Empire and even the Hutt Council thought that this was all done for and Vader had gotten Han Solo, but Boku was not about to quit. Ordered every Hutt vessel in the Jakara system for the glory of the clans, destroy the Imperial flagship. This is when things took a turn. Now the Hutts were directly going for every TIE fighter, gunning down every single one and going for the Executor as well. Admiral Piet was left pondering what to do next. Those fools actually decided to press their attack. Remarkable. "We will teach these slugs a lesson they will soon not forget." Now it was time for Piet to make a very important move, a move that could cost him his life, as Vader is known to be notorious for that. He tells his lieutenant to inform Lord Vader of this escalation. "Of course, sir," says the lieutenant, "but Lord Vader was extremely explicit in his desire not to be disturbed. His exact words were, I believe, 'Do not contact me unless the Emperor himself orders it.'" "I see," says Piet. "That is indeed clear. Very well, Lieutenant. Open a channel to Emperor Palpatine." I think this is a crucial moment when Admiral Piet grew some balls. I think he wanted the Emperor to get involved and actually punish Darth Vader a bit for his recklessness in going after Luke Skywalker and not protecting the Executor. And in the end, everything went as Piet expected. He contacts Lord Vader. "Lord Vader, this is Admiral Piet. Were my instructions not clear, Admiral?" says Vader. "I am not to be disturbed or on anything less than the word of the Emperor himself." "Very clear, Lord Vader. In fact, I just finished speaking with Emperor Palpatine. I appraised him of the situation here, of the Hutt attack. He passed along his orders," as we see Vader hunting down Luke, but in the background, the Empire is getting a bit crushed by the Hutt cartel. "He considers the Empire's arrangement with the Hutts valuable," says Piet, "and wants it preserved, but a message must be conveyed. He wants them cowed, not destroyed. Instead of using the Executor to eradicate the Hutt armada, he has ordered you to end the insurrection personally." Vader hesitates. "I understand." He knows that this means he has to let Luke Skywalker go for now and is not sure if they will ever reconvene. "Admiral, inform the Emperor that it will be done." I will leave you now, young Skywalker, says Vader to Luke. My goal here is complete. I sense your terror at the idea of facing me again. Your skill in the Force does not matter, only your fear. Because of it, you cannot threaten me, and you cannot threaten the Empire. You are no Jedi, says Vader. But Luke has a great retort. That's true, Vader. But the next time we meet, as Vader veers off, I will be. You can see that this experience not only gave Luke the confidence that he needed, but he is very sure of himself at this moment. The confidence is sky high that the next time they meet, he will be a Jedi. And presumably, if the comics don't show otherwise, presumably this is the last time we see Vader and Luke Skywalker close to each other until Return of the Jedi, where Luke surrenders himself to his father, Darth Vader, so that he could test him and basically bring the light out of Darth Vader, in fact bring out Anakin Skywalker himself. But in my mind, more than Vader and Luke at this moment, which we have seen for a couple of issues now, them going back and forth with each other, it's very, very crazy to see Admiral Piet pulling off this move, going against the grain, having seen Darth Vader execute countless amounts of admirals, lieutenants, and everybody else around him that disobeys him. He literally went against Darth Vader's wishes, which was to just let him pursue Luke Skywalker, and brought him in by force, snitching to Emperor Palpatine, basically, just in order to get Darth Vader at his word, which was, I won't budge until the Emperor says something. Vader thought this might never happen, but it actually did. So, very interesting and intriguing aspects to this hierarchy at this moment. In the end, of course, Emperor Palpatine has spoken, and Vader will go straight for the Hutt Council. What will happen to the Hutt Council and to Bogu? Well, that is coming to a definitive close, and I will cover that in the next video coming up. So guys, you need to subscribe for that video, because that will be a very, very glorious one. Thank you guys so much for watching this video, and if you enjoyed, leave a thumbs up down below, subscribe for dailies. Now you can have an awesome day, Star Wars fans. I'll see you in the next video, and may the Force be with you. Until then.